Jazz, your boy M.I. This is the Red Carpet TV show. Don't go nowhere, keep it locked right here. And remember that you're hanging with the ever beautiful, the ever effervescent, the ever special, the ever sexy Wofai. Keep it locked right here, y'all. Peace.
It is the Red Carpet show. I'm here, you're here, Wofai is around.
I'm here. I'm actually chilling with these guys. Of course, we know the name JJC. When you talk about JJC 419, you remember JJC 419 squad then? The side in the Nigerian music industry.
Cool.
I'm alright.
How you doing? I'm JJC. Right here, we've got AB Fresh and a good friend of mine, Silaga. Yes.
JJC, tell us about yourself. Briefly, your fans out there.
Yes, JJC, UK-based Nigerian that's repping the flag. But now I'm back home. And this is what it's all about right now. Nigeria is the best land.
A few years back, you were like the hottest in the Nigerian music industry. You produced lots and lots of big artists. I don't want to go into all the stories. But suddenly, you just went into your shell. You were back in Nigeria. What should we expect from you? Of course, you released a single recently.
Well, right now, all I can say to you is expect a lot from Big Boys All Stars. Just like before, I came with Big Brothers, then I came with Backbone, which has all the stars that you know already. Now there's a new generation, Big Boys All Stars, AB Fresh, Two Craze, Lil Miss, Tipsy, a whole new, fresh, young Nigerian artist.
How does it feel to be in JJC?
Ha, JJC is a great man. In fact, I call him a hero. You know, it's too much. It just, I don't know what to say, but let me just qualify him as a great number one man in Africa.
Wow. How does it feel to be with JJC?
JJC, I salute. Ahu.
Okay.
JJC is my mentor. He brought me into this game, and I can't say much. Just ahu.
Simple. Wow, JJC, we're Africans. That song, that was a song that gained massive airplay all around the world. Like, international stars had to identify and record with it. You said you're going to release some other singles, albums that would be as big as that. But then, looking at yourself, JJC, coming this far and achieving this much, and then along the line, you actually went into your show, like I said. How do you feel?
Well, the thing is, when I came with the We Are African song, it was a very good song, and it's a song that I've been taking to different countries. So even though in Nigeria you don't hear about it, it's actually very big in Sierra Leone, because there's a Sierra Leone version with Sierra Leone artists in it. There's another one in Zimbabwe that's doing big. So the We Are African movement is going on and on. But again, JJC and the Big Boys All Stars, expect the best stuff coming out this year.
They are taking over.
Right now in the Big Boys All Stars, you have two ladies, and your ladies are fantastic.
Sorry, three
ladies. Okay, I just know of Lil Miss and Tipsy. Okay, tell us about
Tipsy. We got Lil Miss, Tipsy, and Noni Zondi, the South African girl with the big bum.
Okay, JJC, I'm sure some other media houses might want to talk with you. So what's your fans out there? Tell your fans, people who love and support you, I want to see more of you. Just speak to them.
All right. For everyone out there who knows or recognizes the JJC and 419, all the Big Boys All-Stars, I thank you. And we do the music for you guys. So keep listening, and I hope that you like it. Ah, ooh.
Naughty, very naughty.
This is Mr. Naughty, Mr. Olumentin, and I'm chilling with Wofai on Red Carpet. Quality.
Sorry?
Good to have you here.
I'm flattered. I'm blushing. I'm turning red. If you say one more thing, I'll turn scarlet.
Please, actually, here for the return of Jennifer. How do you feel at this point in time? I mean, you're all decked up. You're looking very classy.
Thank you very much. I'm part of the cast for the movie. It's my first movie I'm in. I'm more of a radio, TV, MC kind of person. I've never really been in a movie. This is like my first time. So I hope my part will be cool, because I know Funke's part is awesome. Funke is amazing. And believe it or not, I acted in the same scene as the late CD John. Yes.
What's been your inspiration so far?
I look up to a lot of people. First of all, I look up to God. I look up to my pastor, Pastor Paul Ade Farasin, who molds, you know, who shows me how a proper man should be in every ramification. I look up to a few other people, Jay-Z for being successful, P. Diddy for being classy, a couple of people around here, my boss, Amin Musali, for being a driver. You know, he could just... you know, he could just go and go and go and go and never gets tired. You know, I admire that. You know, a lot of people, I don't think I have just one person, because I look at some people for the family person that they are. I look at other people for the fact that they are achievers. I look at other people for the fact that they're classy, you know, and I look at other people for the fact that they're icons.
On the red carpet, you know, the comedy industry is going in leaps and bounds, and people like Ewa have actually stamped a footmark. Like, they've been able to stamp statements in the comedy industry when you're talking about the Nigerian entertainment industry. Hi, Ewa.
Hello, somebody.
I'm very well.
Okay, I'm fine.
Nice outfit, fantastic.
Thank you. It's Yomi Kadra. Okay. He's my younger brother.
Okay. So, how are you feeling at this point in time?
I feel good. I mean, every time somebody in the industry, you know, makes a statement, you know, it's an opportunity to believe that you two can make your own statement. So it's a process of growth. So I'm happy for Funke Akindele.
And I'm so happy I'm getting to stand we had today. Wonder Woman.
Mm-hmm. How are you?
I'm very well.
Oh, we're looking unto Jesus.
Nice to meet you. Lovely outfit. Oh, mommy, always looking stunning at anywhere you find yourself. On the red carpet, from the girl in front of the camera to the girl behind the camera, I mean, you're absolutely stunning. Tell us about your style, briefly.
I like being simple. I like displaying my culture. I'm wearing an Itwebasi piece. Fine small purse, fine small shoe, you know, keeping it simple.
You just released a single, If You Ask Me. Yeah. Now, who am I going to ask? I wish I could actually sing like you, you know. And your singles, like, everybody, it's getting acclaim, international and national acclaim. How do you feel about it? The storyline for that song was wow. Like, it was out of the blue, something nobody ever expected. It's never been done, If You Ask Me.
When I do that song, my mom would say, well, thank God nobody asked you. Well, I think it's a very sensitive issue. It was something I found difficult to talk about until when the producer Kobams encouraged me to talk about it. It's a very strong issue that people need to be aware of. There's incest, there's rape, there's violence against young women and children. And since we have an opportunity to, you know, make music to the extent where people can actually listen to us, we should take our time to say some important things as well.